Linda Gossowich, you made the top point so far. All you need to do is beat whoever comes up against you. How do you feel about that? Do you feel the pressure?
Well, I'm nervous, but I'm not as nervous as if I had to go all the way up. I mean, this way I know I'm guaranteed a second without even, you know, even if I lose. Hopefully I won't, though.
Right. Can you really block out everything else around you and just concentrate on your game?
Most of the time, especially when you're bowling well, you tend to not hear anything, or, you know, you don't hear the clapping, you don't hear much of anything.
So. You mean you don't want this crowd, rating you on and on?
Well, I mean, moral support is good, but, I mean, you know, you really don't hear it, you know. You just concentrate on what you're aiming at, and that's about it. Hopefully everything will go your way.
Mm-hmm. Have you been bowling your average day, or have you been doing better than average?
Well, I started off really bad. I had a really low first game, and I managed to win, so I figured, other than that, I did really well. I bowled way above my average today.
Good luck. How many games do you bowl a week?
I bowl three leagues, which is nine games a week.
Did you find yesterday 8 games at once and now already 5 games before starting here that you might be a little tired? Does that make any difference?
No, I'm not. I don't really feel tired at all.
You look like you're raring to go.
I'm ready.
Good. Let's start bowling. Thank you.
Thank you.
And we're ready now for the final match here with Linda Gossowich and Mickey Arnold.
Mickey has been extremely sharp today. To correct my previous totals, Mickey shot 510 for her last 3 games, which averages out to 170. But Linda and Mickey are longtime friends. They've met in this position before on a first, second, head-to-head battle.
Is it easier to bowl against a friend or against a stranger?
I think you lose track of the fact that it's a friend. You're out there for the professionalism of the win.
And both of them start off with a strike.
It's going to be a
good game coming.
Extremely good game coming up here. As with Darlene Edwards earlier, Linda has just recently been married. And it seems to have given her the spur that she needs. Her husband, Doug, I believe, is also a member of the men's professional tour.
Notice their averages are about the same.
Right. Beautiful shot. Beautiful.
Right. You can tell these two are friends the way they smile at each other.
Yes.
At least they're smiling.
Yes, they are.
It's a good competition.
Both will be equally as happy for either one winning.
Right. That's the way it should be.
Yes.
Oh, bad. Lynn is another happy one. Smile on her face constantly.
Right. Linda came out of the junior leagues and again as an excellent bowler in her own right there, and has seasoned over the past 3 years as an excellent professional bowler.
She'll have to settle for an 8 in that box, but yeah, it's only the beginning.
No, there's 8 boxes left and she's going to take full advantage of them.
Is he doing all? He still is. Is he still going?
Yeah.
Sure.
He had a one guy there.
Right back to it. And okay, Mickey with a good hit here again. Could get a good handle on this match.
Get in there.
Oh, back too far over.
And a lucky break out there.
Good.
It's a makeable.
Yeah.
Aside from collecting the tournament wins, Linda also collects keychains, crabs, and spoons. I certainly hope the crabs are of the non-live variety. She's throwing a tremendous ball right now. Okay, sets herself.
Get in there.
She needs to stay on top. It's not a bad break.
She's going to have to work for this one. It's got to
yes,
be positioned
there's a lot of
right.
space. A lot of space down there between those pins.
And
get up.
Oh!
That's
so close.
That's the problem.
So close. But $10, maybe.
She'll be pushing at it. Right on. Linda had a 211 when she was a major girl, which is an 16 to 18 year old category.
Wow.
So that's a tremendous, tremendous score at that age. Her high game now, though, is 223. Going to have to get that ball working to get past what Mickey has. And eight.
Couldn't pull that one off.
No. As they would say, she's going up on 16. She seems to have a good line on that. If she can get through 15 and put some marks together.
And
just a tough break. The ball didn't have the speed on it to stay on the head pin, and it slides off, which is why the five stays up.
She's heading it up, isn't it?
So it's not only accuracy, it's speed that counts.
Yes, you've let up on the ball, it loses its rotation, and you end up nice. That should. If the ball isn't going fast enough when it gets in there, it will bounce off the pins and just take out the preliminary front ones and leave you up with a with that type of setup.
So when practicing, we should try for a fast ball besides.
Yes.
That's why the men's scores are a little higher than a women's score.
Men have a tendency of throwing more strikes. They are stronger. They can bring pins back off the wall, out of the pit. Break up the splits. But there are a few girls out there on the lanes today that I would probably pit against quite a few men. If she lets that spin, she might catch a better break than she's got. But it is moving away.
At least they're all on one side of the alley.
Definitely a bonus.
Yes,
that's where she wanted to put it. Well, second place in this event pays $500, so both girls are going to come back with a pretty good paycheck for doing something they enjoyed doing.
What's the entry fee for?
The entry fee is $35 for each event. You pay a preliminary membership fee also to join, which is $35 at the moment.
So these girls are going home with money in their pocket.
Oh. Okay.
Who puts up the money for the prizes?
The prize money comes from the entry fees. While we're here, the house donates the games and the lanes to the tour.
Mm-hmm.
He does not get the lineage money, and he pays a franchise fee to host it here. He, in turn, as a proprietor, will either host a pro-am or sell ads to get his money back.
Mm-hmm.
But it's a courtesy from the houses, which, you know, the proprietors have been very, very good with. So any money coming in, minimal amount goes towards expenses. Being our inaugural year, all of our jobs are volunteer.
Mm-hmm.
There's no salaried positions. Next year there will be, with a director and a treasurer.
Oh, that was pinfall.
That was a tough hit, but it is a makeable. She can hit the three pins off to the right. Send the 5 into the 7, the ball into the 10. It will go. And she'll be trying for it. Just like that.
She was trying
just like all the way.
But the one pin left didn't want to go down.
Definitely a good try.
Nice. Great on.
A little excitement out there for the spectators.
We're more than halfway through this game. Mickey still got her lead.
She's got a 26-pin advantage and no marks up.
So it's still anybody's game.
Right.
Let's
see what Linda does here now.
Remember Bull about an ass to block? He came out of Washington.
Oh, too strong, too full. She'll have to pin this out. And hope that Mickey makes a mistake, but it just doesn't look like Mickey wants to make any today. It was a good try on it.
Took half them down, and now for the others.
That's the 10.
She did it.
Okay.
But they know they need those strikes and spares.
All right. Oh, it was a soft hit.
Well, she may be getting tired.
It could be, and sometimes when you know you've got the lead that you have, you tend to let up a little bit. You've got to just keep driving.
Now,
if you lay the ball down, it slides, and that was a good shot at it.
This might be what Linda needs.
Sometimes it's the spur. You get the little juices flowing, and she can come back with a good mark here, and a couple of them.
Oh, yeah.
Someone else.
105 in the seventh to 80 for Linda.
It's a 25-pin lead. Linda still needs to come up with some big marks, and she's got three boxes left.
Well, she had a strike at the beginning and in the third box. Now, if she had two more, put them together, she stands a chance.
That's about what she needs now. But Mickey's there.
Meanwhile.
Mickey's relaxed.
Here's
comfortable.
Oh, she knew. She shouldn't have missed that. Yeah, before she turned her back on it, she knew she had it. This time, she was watching it right to the end.
You just kind of hope that maybe you'll catch a piece of it. But that's it. Linda's got to come up here. That's a freak.
That was a harder hit, too.
Yeah,
but
sometimes with the new plastic pins, though, the harder the hit, the more devastating the leave can be. Because it tends to bounce off itself rather than push back. But she'll be trying for it.
Oh, yeah. All that garbage you can put on it.
She bowls right from the edge of the alley.
Right. She's a tall girl. She's 5'7". And she probably needs it for the slide and her own steps.
Still 25 pins down. No. Yeah.
25 pins, but she lost that one.
Yeah. At this point, Mickey must know that
she's
got it.
Yeah, she's got a good spot. She's in a good spot right now.
Oh,
as I say, Linda is tough. That's what we call making the spare first.
Yeah.
Get rid of the three pins that you might miss.
Doing it the hard way.
Yes.
That's it.
Coming in there. Right on. Looks like Mickey will go home with the first place prize check this time. But the next time they meet, and they probably will meet again, could be a different story.
Well, it's a cushion on it anyway, you know.
And she did it from just squeaking in to the finals here.
That's
it. Now she had to go all the way.
That's exactly it.
Never give up hope. Now to fill this strike.
It's another good ball.
Looked good, but 10 pin remaining.
It looks like she's just about finished off in style. Right on the edge and right on it. Right. She checked the score, but she's got a 35 lead plus.
I think she just realized that she made it.
Yes, she just a big smile came across her face.
And she gets one more ball.
Oh. Yeah. That's it. Okay. She didn't need it anyway. But it was four count. Nikki's total for those four games was 6.59. That's an excellent, excellent score. Linda will finish out now.
Mickey's sitting there saying, I don't believe it.
That's it. That's exactly what she's doing. Linda was just a little too sharp today with the head pin.
But look out next time.
Yes, definitely.
A good game.
Arnold successfully came up from the fifth position. She defeated all of her opponents, Darlene Edwards, Karen Smith, Linda Goswich, and she did it in style.
She sure did.
And now she's just going to accept the congratulations of the girls. It's absolutely fantastic. Fantastics. I can't say enough about it. I'm a bowler. I know how hard that is.
She kept it up all the way through.
Completely. Completely.
Sandy, I want to thank you very much for joining us here and keeping us abreast of what the girls are doing when they're not bowling.
Oh, I had a good time.
Well, that certainly was exciting. It's always a pleasure to watch the women's finals. The women's always provide an air of excitement and suspense whenever they perform. I'd really like to have a round of applause for the five finalists and all of the girls who participated this weekend. On behalf of the Women's National Duck Pin Association, I would also like to take this opportunity to express our gratitude to Hippo Corinti and his hardworking staff here at Holiday Lanes. They certainly made our weekend an easy one, and I'd like for everybody to please give them a big round of applause. Without any further delay, I would like to present now the awards to our finalists. Finishing fifth today from Glendale, Maryland, collecting a check of $200, Darlene Edwards. Our fourth finisher today from Baltimore, Maryland, collecting a check of $250, Joanne Jarzynski. Our third place finisher for today, also from Baltimore, Maryland, collecting a check of $350, Karen Smith. Congratulations. Our second place finisher, also from Baltimore, Maryland, collecting a check of $500, Linda Gosiewicz. Before we present our first place award, I would like to present to you Dave Plumley. Dave has been your hardworking counterman this weekend, and he will present the awards. Okay. Dave, would you like to say a few words?
It has been a true pleasure working here this past weekend with all of the ladies. I have been extremely impressed with how well they bowl, but how well they also present their activity, and it's been a tremendous joy. And I speak for everybody here at Holiday Lanes, and on behalf of Mr. Corinti, and I enjoyed it very much. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dave. Okay, well, we started out Saturday morning with 108 bowlers, and now we are down to one. This is our winner. There's a bit of deja vu here. Last year, these two bowlers that you just saw competed again in the Miller High Life Open, although the results were different. Last year, Linda Gosiewicz won. This year, bowling a stupendous four-game set of 659, averaging 164. She missed six pins and made 28 marks and averaged 144 for the weekend. Mickey Arnold. Mickey, would you like to say a few words?
I'd just like to thank everyone here, and we'll see you at Wheaton.
Okay. All right, once again, I want to take this opportunity to thank everyone, and good evening.
Mickey Arnold, you did it. You came all the way the hard way. You had to bowl another four games at the end there. Did you feel as confident as you looked?
I felt pretty confident. I was a little shaky before we started. I think we all are. If you don't have some cases of nerves, you're crazy. But my hands were calm and the ball was there.
You seemed to be able to concentrate with no problem when you got up there. It was a good game.
Thank you very much. It was about the best four-game set I think I've ever put together.
That's what everybody's been saying. Your score was fantastic. Do you think you can keep this up? Is it going to happen again next time?
Of course.
That's the attitude we like. It was very good. And what do you have to say about the alleys here? You mentioned that it helps to be able to stay on the same alleys for each of the final games. That is an advantage?
Coming from the position that I did, the wild card, and being on a pair of lanes where my ball found a groove and stayed there, it was definitely an advantage. Normally, if we were not being televised, we would be moving pairs of lanes, and then it's a constant adjustment period. But I think I definitely had an advantage.
Well, it certainly showed, and I wish you a lot of luck in the future. Maybe we'll see you back here again in another championship bowling tournament.
For sure, I'm the defending champ now.
You have to come back.
That's right.
Good. Congratulations.
Thank you, Carol. We'll be right back.
Now I'm back on my feet.